What's up, peers, and welcome to the World Crypto Network, here with the new series on how to do a really secure GPG setup with the YubiKey, thanks to the awesome guide by Dr. Drew. And today I assume that you already have Tails installed and maybe even a Chaos Key with you and a YubiKey, plus a couple USB sticks as described yesterday. And make sure that your software is all up to date and that you have all these dependencies that are described here in the guide. Make sure that here you can also check your entropy. And when you have a Chaos Key, then this entropy will not be at a meager 800 or something, but much more at like a 3000 or 4000. So with a Chaos Key, this will generate a lot more secure private keys much faster. And then also here, when creating a key, we can first make sure that we have a hardened GPG config that has some additional options, which Dr. Drew here recommends for securing good keys. I'm not going to go into the details. And this is a well peer-reviewed guide. So you can take these for now valid, of course, don't trust verify if you really want to get into it. But let's start with creating a master key. And the master key is going to be a private and public key pair, often RSA signature, that is going to be your long-term identity. So this is a key which you will want to keep secret and hidden to yourself for maybe 30, 40, 50 years, as long as you live, maybe even afterwards, okay? So this is something for really long-term storage. And make sure that this is going to be secured surely. So this is why the setup is so all-encompassing, right? We really want to make sure that this secret number that we are generating right here is a secure one and not compromised, okay? And also why we have to make sure that the backup and the usage is convenient, okay? So take your time with this, go through this really in-depth written guide, and take this video more as an encouragement for further research. First, we can check here if we can generate a good random number. And if we get no error here, then this is awesome. Or we can also use this as a passphrase for encrypting then all the or the entire GPG setup. So make sure that you have a secure passphrase. You could also do a Diceware password list, something which we'll get into much later in this guide. We then can start with the GPG setup in the expert mode, because this is an expert guide, and we will do a full key generation ceremony. So this will take us into all the nitty-gritty details, and we'll have the maximum amount of editability. First, we will select key number 8, which is an RSA key, and where we can set our own capability. So again, we want to have full control here. And this guide is very exhaustive, as I said. So we first toggle E, that is, we toggle the encrypt capability, and we also at the same time toggle then S, which is the sign capability of this first master key, which we will generate. And the signing and encryption key together is the certificate key, the master key. So then after we have toggled on both sign and encrypt, then we can finish with Q. And we can next choose how large we want to have the key size of our RSA key. Standard is 2048 bits. We want to go the maximum. We want to be as secure. And 4096 bits is quite large enough. It should be fine for many years to come in terms of brute force attacks. And for this master key, we do not want to set a year limitation to when the key will expire. So the validity is zero. The key will never expire. Later for the subkey, we want to have key rotation. But as I said earlier, the master key, which we generate right now, is your long-term digital identity. So make sure that you do not have, that you make, or that this key does not expire. And verify that everything is correct. Then here in the confirmation. And now you need to get you need to verify your identity, right? So this again is your real identity. You are going to use this for communication, which you want to do under your official name, or maybe as a pseudonym. Okay, so this can be your real official name or your pseudonym. It works for the exact same way. And for example, here, if this is your real name, put in your real name here and your real email address that you will use, that you're currently using. You can at a later time, and we'll go through this, add new email addresses or new identities in general as well. You can also add a comment. Maybe if this is maybe if this is something for an organization or you want to have your job title or something, it doesn't matter. Here, a comment is some arbitrary text that you can add. And verify that the user ID is correct with O for OK. And now now the computer is generating a lot of random bytes. And again, when you have the chaos key, this is going to be extremely fast with a lot of entropy. If you do not have the chaos key, now is the time to hack on your keyboard like a moron. So be active, introduce uncertainty into the computer so that all the speed and the heat and whatnot is all a little bit chaotic. So hack on the keyboard, click on the mouse, and maybe, I don't know, shake the laptop, whatever. But make sure that you do some physical activity on your laptop to introduce enough randomness for the setup. But regular key clacking should be enough. And then this is it. Then we have generated right here your first and, the master key for your PGP setup. So this is a RSA key with 4096 bits. And this right here is the public key version. And with your key identity right here. And it was created on the current date, and it is the C, the certificate key. It is the master key. The fingerprint right here, which is just the large hash of the short hash of the public key, is right here. And you can use this for the identity and with your user ID, both the name and the email that we have specified. And if you want to export this, then you can simply use the GPG command export with key ID equals, and then you use this key ID right here, which is exactly half of the key fingerprint, is the key ID. So here the last part of the fingerprint is the key ID. And then you can get an entire public key which corresponds to this key ID. So a very large script. And this again here, that is all for the master key. This is going to be your long-term identity. So be really, really careful and make sure that all the setup is done in tails as is described, of course. So we want to be offline on a hardware that is secure and generate this hopefully with a chaos key to make sure that it is a good and secure key. But don't overthink it, to be honest. Computers can handle private key cryptography. And if you do this thing here, as it is described in the setup, on a rather secure hardware with tails booted, with all the secure setup of the software, I think you should be fine, okay? So don't stress it, but this is something important, so take good care. And Piers, this was the master key setup. In the next videos, we will do the subkeys, and I will explain the differences here. So thank you very much for joining me, and see you on the next show. Bye-bye.